this is the problem that many investors have, and they're not even aware it's a problem. They'll say, or you'll say to them, why are you investing? And they'll say, to have more money. And it's not specific enough to be helpful in formulating a portfolio. So just more is not an answer, or to have a bigger portfolio is not an answer. Why? What are you trying to do with the money? When are you trying to use it? We've got to ask these very, very specific questions, and it's actually better to not have a perfect answer than having not asked the questions at all. I've been a financial advisor all my adult life, the first and only job I've ever had. I appear on CNBC's Halftime Report and Closing Bell each week. And I run an investment advisory firm in Manhattan with 33 employees and about 1,200 households that we're responsible to. The way I invest my money starts off as being very conventional. The same exact asset allocation strategies that we're using in client portfolios, all of the employees of my firm are using them in their retirement accounts. So we're eating our own cooking. The same funds, the same proportions of equities and fixed income. Where my portfolio deviates slightly from what we're recommending to clients is that I will make investments based on relationships I have in my personal life. I have friends that launch fintech companies. I understand that on paper, these are unnecessary risks that I'm taking, but they make me feel good. I like to back people who I trust and who I'm friends with, even when those investments don't work out, I still appreciate the journey. So you will find me frequently investing in ETFs that my friends launch, in software startups. And what a lot of those things have in common is not only do I trust the person who's launching it because it's a friend of mine, but oftentimes I'm a user of that product. I believe in it that much. So I will do things that are on a spreadsheet basis, not necessary for my own retirement, but I just want to. And the same applies to owning individual stocks. I currently own shares in Apple, in Alphabet, in Amazon, in Nvidia, in JP Morgan, in Store Capital. These are companies that I'm sure they're well represented in the index funds that I own in retirement accounts, but I wanted to be overweight them and own a little bit more. I track the companies, I listen to their conference calls, and I believe in their products and services, and I don't live or die based on whether or not they go up or down. You hope they work out over time. So far, not every investment I've ever made has worked out. That's part of the journey of being an investor. I can get as much diversification as I need with indexes. We use direct indexes, mutual funds, but sometimes I'll want to own a stock. And I'm allowed to, it's my money. I work my ass off to make it. And if I wanna blow myself up in an oil driller, I have the right as an American to do that. So my portfolio will be a mix of mutual funds, ETFs, individual stocks, fintech startups, and products that friends of mine launch out into the marketplace. And they don't have to make sense to anyone else, they only have to make sense to me.
Invest in you. Ready, set, grow. CNBC and Acorns.